After the First World War, the Treaty of Versailles imposed such severe and punishing terms on the defeated Germany that its economy collapsed, and many of its people had to live in extreme poverty. It was these conditions that helped create the environment for fascism to rise and was a direct cause of the next war. After the end of the Second World War in 1945, the Allies were determined not to repeat those mistakes. Germany's economy was rebuilt with the help of a great deal of American money, and it was decided that the best way to ensure peace was through treaties that would bind European countries together in mutually beneficial trade, to the extent that war between them would be unthinkable. The most important raw materials in the industrial world of the time were coal and steel, so in the Treaty of Paris in 1951, the European Coal and Steel Community was formed by six countries: Belgium, France, West Germany, Italy, the Netherlands, and Luxembourg. The United Kingdom played an important role in setting up the community, but declined to join because at the time, and wrongly as it turned out, it thought that with its still large empire it did not need to belong. As time went on, the European Coal and Steel Community was superseded by the European Economic Community, or EEC. In 1973, the EEC expanded to include Denmark, Ireland, and the United Kingdom, although the United Kingdom had originally applied for membership in 1961 and had been blocked by France. Greece joined in 1981, followed by Spain and Portugal in 1986, three countries who had not been able to join previously because at the time they were not democracies. The emphasis at the time was still trade. In 1986, the Single European Market was created, which standardised trade regulation across member states and created the largest single trading market in the world. Businesses could trade freely throughout the market without import or export restrictions, and people were free to move anywhere in the community to look for work. As the European Economic Community grew, the old structures needed to change, and in 1993 the European Union was created. It is formed of seven main institutions, most of which it inherited from the Coal and Steel and the Economic Community. The three most important of which are the European Council, which is formed from the elected governments of each member nation and decides the priorities and direction of the EU, and chooses the members of the European Commission, which is the body that enforces EU treaties, manages the day-to-day operation of the Union, and proposes new European laws. Finally, there is the European Parliament, formed of directly elected members who vote on whether to pass those laws and themselves elect the President of the Commission. The European Parliament represents the largest democratic electorate in the world after India. As time went on, the European Union was joined by Austria, Finland, Sweden, the Czech Republic, Estonia, Hungary, Latvia, Lithuania, Poland, Slovakia, Slovenia, Malta, Cyprus, Romania, Bulgaria, and Croatia, bringing the total membership up to 28 of the 50 states in the European continent. The European Union is not the only international European organisation, although it is the most important. One of the most commonly confused European institutions is the European Court of Human Rights, or ECHR, a body largely shaped by Britain, which oversees human rights legislation and is not, as many think, part of the European Union. The European Union has been tested to near breaking point in recent years between the crash of the global economy and the crisis in the Middle East, yet it does for now endure. On the 23rd of June 2016, the United Kingdom will be voting on whether to remain a part of the EU, and in future videos we'll be looking more in depth into the operation of the European Union and its effects on Europe.